This is most of the colony. They call them colonizers. They're saying these birds are colonizers. They're actually a family. This is one family. And as you can see, they're not hassling the crested pigeon at all. There are some babies in there. They're the ones going cheep cheep. And I'm getting more and more of these birds, this family, every day. There are those up there, those beautiful little birds. If I can focus on it. Up there. Those are the scaly-breasted lorikeets. Very loving little birds. Very lovely little birds. And so these. Very active. These honey eaters. Now that bird is being submissive to the other bird. One on the left is being submissive. That sound is their friendly sound when they want the other bird to follow. See, birds need to preen so that their new feathers can grow well. And they can't preen their own heads. And this is also the bonding between the birds. And parrots mate for life. And these two little scaly-breasted lorikeets are part of this mixed flock with the rainbow lorikeets. The rainbow lorikeets have, they're up the top of the tree there. That's one of their babies that you can hear. That's one of them. That's not the baby though. Babies on the side. And I've been getting about five or so new rainbow lorikeets every day. And so I'd have to say that Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary has been quite a success over the last month or so. This is a native pigeon, a crested pigeon. and their feathers on their wings refract light. That's why they glisten like that. They glint, purple and green. Beautiful birds, aren't they? This one's come and landed right here. They're getting really very tame. As you can see, they don't do the alarm call to me. Things I look after them. And they really like this perch that I've set up for them. With their come and catch me sound. Alright, so we've got a few rainbow lorikeets just come down. Once one or two come down, the rest follow. There's a scaly breasted lorikeet as well. See all these different species all feeding happily together. It's about a meter and a half away from me. And Yeah, I think bird watching is a very healing pastime. I worked out that if you distribute the bread like this, they don't fight over it. And they don't squabble. It's like each at their own little table. And they chat to each other while they're eating. And sometimes they say, go away and find your own table. My mother, who was feeding the bread all at the same time early in the morning, would have these the dominant bird chasing off all the other ones. And that was how it was when I first started feeding them. But I've refined my feeding technique. At the Currumbin Bird Sanctuary, they feed the birds, or they used to anyway, feed them a mixture of bread soaked in honey. But they don't really need the extra sugar, they can get that from the wild. And I've had people on my YouTube warning me about the danger of feeding them dry food. So I said that it can block up their gullets, and as you can see, these birds are extremely healthy. Now that's one of the behaviors that these noisy miners do. They go up and peck each other around the eyes sometimes. That's their alarm call. Now that is the blue-faced honeyeater. I can hear it. Oh, there, I can see it as well. It's just right up there. And they heard something exciting, probably somebody else feeding them, and so they all flew away. But there are some who are roosting in the tree all day. As I said, they come here at dawn and they're here till dusk. Now you can see those noisy miners playing with the blue-faced honeyeaters. They're chasing each other, and they're not fighting. They're just playing. So yeah, my mother was doubtful about birds playing when I spoke to her today, and I'd never really realized that birds play as such, but yes, parrots are very playful birds, and I'm noticing that so are honeyeaters, and so are doubtless many other different types of social bird. Play is an instinct in human beings, and it's an instinct in mammals. Darwin actually said that insects play, and he had observed insects playing. So if insects can play, of course birds play. And yeah, that's I'm going to upload this onto YouTube, because I have uploaded, or I'm in the process of uploading Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary on a rainy day. And this is Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary on a sunny day. And what's delightful about it is, yes, it's the same day, morning and afternoon. Oh, but before I go, I've got to show you my new visitor. This is a male scrub turkey. He came to the garden for the first time this morning, so he doesn't know me yet. These birds are almost flightless. They can run really fast. Their Latin names, their family name is Megapodiae, because they have big feet. Very strong feet. And the male has that yellow wattle, the yellow collar as they call it. And it's the male that builds the nest. In fact, the males in the family build the nest. The female lays the egg, or the eggs, and there can be up to 30. And the males carefully arrange the eggs and regulate the temperature of the nest by sticking their red heads inside the nest. And what's amazing is that they can control the litter as to whether they're male or female birds that hatch out by a slight variation in the temperature of the nest. Now that is quite amazing. More like bower birds in some ways. And they're like dinosaurs, and they're like mammals or kiwis, flightless birds of New Zealand, and moas. So yeah, these are quite amazing birds. The females have been coming to the garden for a while. It's quite rare to see a male coming in here. Male's much shyer. And I had a little baby, tiny little one, about 5 or 6 inches long. And this little baby stayed overnight a couple of days ago, and I noticed that the crow looked at it as if it was a tasty morsel. And I also noticed that the noisy miners tried to chase away this little baby scrub turkey, which was actually smaller than them. And the baby was really very scared. So I tried to encourage them to be a little bit nicer to the baby scrub turkey, but one doesn't have control over these things. It It's all in their instinct. I have noticed they haven't done the alarm call, but there aren't any noisy miners. The birds come and go as they please at Dr. Romesh's bird sanctuary. And as you can see, he's quite scared of me. And then they're back. So this is the way it is all day. Birds coming and going. And yes, it's that alarm call is for the scrub turkey, not for me. So yeah.